Tomorrow, April 28th, all of the content that we are going to go over in this video will be out live for everyone. One more time, tomorrow, April 28th. Super excited, there's a bunch of content, now let's dive in. Let's start you guys off with the big announcements that they started off with. Teostra and Kushala Dora are now coming back. I can't believe it. I'm extremely hyped, right? And it makes sense because they already had most of their renewed movesets in World and Iceborne already. So it makes perfect sense, but bringing in Camellios really completes the original trio from Monster Hunter Freedom Unite 2. My god, super freaking excited about this. I can't believe it. We're getting three Elder Dragons tomorrow. If you haven't seen my video on how I feel about the current endgame, it felt a little lacking with just Narwa being the optimal way. We got options, boys! We got options! And I'm so excited about it. Outside of these three Elder Dragons being added tomorrow, April 28th, we are also getting new Apex monsters, right? We're getting Apex Diablos, which was revealed today, right next to Apex Rathalos. So now, at first I thought, well, why is that important? At the end of the day, it'll be cool, it'll be fun, but grinding for the Apex monsters aren't really that exciting because they're stuck inside of the rampages. Until they weren't. Guys, they did it. They did what none of us really thought they were gonna do. Apex Arzeros outside Apex Rathian, which is just a pink Rathian with a glow. Apex Mizutsune with exploding bubbles. Yo, honestly, man, I can't even begin to explain how shocked I am that they actually are allowing us to hunt the Apex monsters outside of the rampages. Now, based on their wording, it was a little weird the way that they worded it. It makes me think that only the current Apex monsters are going to be available to hunt in regular hunts, and not so much the, the newer monsters, the Rathalos and the Diablos. Now, it makes me think, what is the purpose still of hunting these monsters? And I'm pretty sure what's gonna happen is that the drop rate for like the gems and the rubies are gonna be a lot higher when fighting the Apex versions of a monster. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like every time I fight an Apex Rathian or Apex Mizutsune in a rampage, yeah, it takes a while, but I feel like I have a higher chance to get a ruby because I feel like I've gotten rubies 3 out of 5 times or 3 out of even 6 times half the time when doing the Apex Rathian rampage. Either way, it's super exciting that we can farm these Apex monsters with our friends or alone to test our skills and have a great time, even if the reason to farm for armor and weapons just isn't there outside of the rampage weapons, which are good, don't get me wrong, but it's still a good chance to have a lot of fun with a good challenge that Rise is kind of lacking right now. And on top of that, hopefully being able to gem farm will be great as well. And of course, the arrival of the Elder Dragons bring with them their weapons and armor and unique skills. So we're going to have a lot more fun putting different things together, and I'm super, super excited for it. Now, let's get in to the DLC. And to start it all off, they're giving away one free character edit voucher, which is great for people like me who don't like the voice that they picked under Hunter. I like him visually, but I don't like his voice. I will always say that I don't understand why we even have to pay for vouchers in the first place and why it can't just be an in-game option, but hey, I guess you gotta make your money somewhere. Speaking of voices, they are giving us the Elder Fugan and Minoto voices, which is actually really cool. I think it's coming in a Monster Hunter Rise DLC Pack 2, and I'll definitely be buying it because I like options and I love content. We're also going to be able to buy new layered armor, which I think is really, really cool looking for us and our buddies. On top of that, there's going to be a bunch of gestures that we can get, which is cool because there are some gestures that you don't have to buy, you can unlock, and more stickers. Why is he happy in Maggie's mouth? On top of that, we have new hairstyles, pet clothing, and more. We'll just have to wait for the update to see what more really is. We're also going to be getting new event quests, which is what's going to help us get new stickers and gestures as well. And again, I love anything that lets me work for my reward and not have to pay for it. On top of some really dope looking sunglasses, which I'm never taking off. So now let's talk about the Hunter rank cap unlock. Very important stuff right here. So for those of you who don't know, at the end of a mission, you have a Hunter rank bar, which is basically an experience bar that'll go up every time it gets full. So right now the cap is 7, but starting tomorrow, it's gonna be able to go up to 8, 9, 10, and we don't know what the new cap is. What's important to know is that the higher the Hunter rank, not only the more experience do you have as a Hunter, and players can see that, but you unlock different and more difficult quests. We can see here that for Hunter rank 8, we get to unlock Camellios, which is great. That's just one more Hunter rank up. On top of that, we're going to be getting advanced rampages, and I can imagine that by continuing to raise our hunter rank, we're going to unlock all the elder dragons. Probably in hunter rank 8, we'll probably get all the elders, and maybe hunter rank 9, we'll get the apex monsters, or hunter rank 10, one or the other. Of course, there's going to be a limit to what we unlock as we go up until content continues to drop, but still, it's really, really cool that that's coming, and they fucking did it and gave us craftable layered armors. No, I didn't think that we were going to get craftable layered armors until the Monster Hunter Rise equivalent to the Iceborne expansion, but no, we got it now. So you know we're all going to be hunting for these layered armors starting tomorrow. So now let's go over the major new features at once. For the added story elements, your hunter rank cap will be unlocked when certain conditions are met. New monsters will start intruding on some quests, which is cool. I can imagine that an Apex Rathian might intrude on your Teostra hunt, for example. Then we have the added elements after unlocking the hunter rank cap, starting with new monsters will appear in village and hub quests. I love this. I love this because you're always going to have your more casual hunters who just want to go to village and they don't really care for hub. They just want to come in and have a good time, do a couple hunts and leave. So I love that they're going to keep on developing the content for the more casual players in the village as well as the more hardcore players in the hub. New monsters will appear in the rampage. New quests, arena quests, and requests will be available. I didn't mention it, but in the arena quest, there's going to be more difficult arena quests for like solo players. So they showed off Magnamalo and Rajang at once. That's going to be really cool to see players throw that up online. I actually can't wait. I'm really excited for that. New skills and rampage skills will be available. Of course, this is also tied to the Elder Dragon armor. So these new skills is going to be great to see how people utilize it for new builds, if they're viable enough. The armor upgrade level cap will be unlocked, which is dope, and it makes me think that the Elder Dragons are going to be hitting very hard, which is something that is much needed in the game. It's much needed for, you know, the difficulty of Monster Hunter Rise, because right now it's a little lacking. So the fact that we get to upgrade the armor even more makes me feel like these Elder Dragons are going to be hitting that much harder. So I look forward to that. But the most amazing part is new decorations will be available to forge at the smithy. I'm super excited about that. Do you guys think we're gonna get a weakness exploit? I don't. I think they're gonna mess with us and not give us weakness exploit to craft. But if we do get it, that's great. It'll alleviate a lot of the problems that are coming with the charm tables for the, you know, the talismans. But it should be noted that they did say they are fixing the bugs with the charm table, so there's that. Let's see how that turns out. Still, being able to craft new decorations is always going to be great for min-maxing our builds, you know, to our favor. And if we can make the weakness exploit decoration, then that's going to make it that much more great for all of us who weren't lucky enough with these charms. And finally, we have that Palico and Palamute layered armor will be available to forge at the Buddy Smithy. Palico and Palamute level cap will be unlocked to level 50, and the default level for Palico and Palamute hired from the Buddy Scout will be raised. All in all, really awesome content, really awesome update. Can't wait for tomorrow, April 28th, I'll say it again, for all of us to dive in and experience everything that the game has to offer. And with that, guys, I'm pretty sure I've covered basically everything for the news roundup for today. If there's anything that I missed, please put it down in the comment section below, and I cannot wait to dive into all this extra content for you guys. Please look forward to my hammer guide, which should be out by this weekend, and never forget, wear your crown and live your roar. Take care, Pride.